Hey, what's going on guys? Jolts here, back with another video, and today we're going to go ahead and go over the hotfixes. So Gearbox is still on a buffing spree, and a lot more things got a buff. Yeah, that's pretty awesome. Anyways, to load your hotfixes, make sure you're playing online and sit at the main menu for a second. You should see a sign pop up behind your character saying hotfixes applied. Once you see that, jump into your game and you are good to go. Before we go over the 13 weapon buffs, let's go ahead and go over some other fixes. Alright, for the first one, Typhon would sometimes get stuck at the Shadow of Starlight area. I do believe that's at the Pyre of the Stars map, so that has been fixed. Jabber Mogwai was sometimes not dropping loot at the correct rate. That was fixed, and I believe they're talking about how pretty much when you kill him every run, you get the Hellfire. So I'm assuming when they're saying correct rate, they're fixing that drop to not be, you know, guaranteed. Now, I don't know for sure, I haven't tested it, this is what the notes say. Okay, so on to the character fixes. Remove the Gunner's General Winter Minigun Damage Penalty and Cryo Penalty. That's pretty cool, so that augment's gonna be even better. Adjusted the Gunner's Exploding Bullet skill to match her current damage output, which was sometimes higher than stated on the skill description. So that augment got a balance, so I think it's gonna be based on level now. Your Moses level, I mean. For Flak, the Furious Attack skill would round up values, and the damage output would appear inconsistent. That has been fixed. Basically, under the hood, the skill might give you, you know, 1.4% damage per point. On the card, it would show 1%. It wouldn't show the decimal value. That's just an example, not the exact amount for the skill, but you know, I'm glad they're looking into it. Also for Flak, the Hunter's Eye skill was also showing incorrect values. That has been fixed too. Alright, so Gearbox is aware of minimaps being underleveled for your normal mode playthrough, so they're adjusting areas to better match your player's level when you get there. So they're going to be balancing minimaps in the future, but for now, we do have one right here. They adjusted various areas and side missions on Necro Tefeo to match your player's level. Enemies at the anvil should now match the average level for the player. Again, they are aware of minimaps being underleveled, and those will be fixed in a later hotfix or patch. Alright, on to the 13 weapon buffs. For the first one, we have the Sickle, and yes, they did buff the Sickle last week for the hotfix, but it did not buff the Splash version of it. So the Splash version of Sickles now have better stats. That's pretty awesome since I do like that gun. Up next, the Boomer. They increased the weapon damage on that. Before, it was kind of lackluster, and it worked okay on Moe's with the right setup, but now it should be a lot better. The Garcia. They increased the fire rate and projectiles per shot. This weapon was already really good, but now it's even better. They buffed the Hellfire, thank you. It was always sad that the Hellfire was a god tier weapon in BL1, and really not all that great for BL2, the pre-sequel, and, you know, BL3. Now, they increased the damage on it, and also increased the damage over time on it. Yeah, in Borderlands 1, this thing would burn away your enemies. Hopefully with this buff, it'll do the same in BL3. The Hyperfocus XC41. They increased the damage on it. Pretty cool, I do like that gun too. Next up we have the Link. They also increased the damage on it. Alright, that's pretty cool, and I'm really hoping they do the same treatment for all Atlas pistols. Next up, they increased the damage on the Nemesis. And hey, that's awesome, because you do get that gun pretty early on from Mouthpiece, so that could be a really strong choice for an early game weapon. The Nimble Jag. They increased the weapon damage on it, and also added 100% bonus critical hit damage. This weapon's all about accuracy, so that's a really good choice for the gun. We have the Ogre. Increased the weapon damage on it. Alright, that's pretty cool. It was already really strong for non-Mayhem mode, but now it should hopefully be a viable choice for Mayhem 4. This one sort of caught me by surprise. They buffed the damage on the One Pump Jump. Yeah. This shotgun was already insane before the weapon buff, and now it's going to be on a whole other level. So I'm excited to mess with that one. Up next, we have the Roys and Thorns. They increased the weapon damage on that. Yeah, that was needed because that pistol before was pretty bad. The Sawbar. They increased the weapon damage on it, and the projectiles will split closer to you. Thank you, it was needed. Now it should function similar to the way it was in Borderlands 2. We have the Skeksil. They increased the projectile damage. So like when you shoot it, it'll shoot out the small rockets, and those should be doing more. For weapon number 13, we have the Tankman's Shield. They increase the maximum damage cap by 200% and increase the percent damage awarded for each kill. That's pretty awesome because it is a Mayhem 4 exclusive drop from Trond, so it should be a top tier gun. Alright, that's going to be it for all the hotfixes, so let me know below in the comments what your favorite one is, guys. For me, I'm definitely going to say the Hellfire because, you know, I love that gun in Borderlands 1, and that gun is going to go great on my Splash Moe's or Elemental Amara. There's so many things it could work on. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and of course, if you did, then please be sure to leave a like, because that'd be awesome. And if you guys really enjoyed it, be sure to sub. You guys have a great day, and I will see you all later. Peace out.